Good morning, all of you. Next, we are going to see electromeric effect. Electromeric effect. This is another type of electron movement. See, double bond C, H, H, H. Here, this pi bond is very loose. This is sigma bond, what is pi bond? Pi bond is very loose. It can be shifted to that carbon or to this carbon. If it is getting shifted to that carbon, then that carbon will be carrying minus charge. That time this carbon will be carrying positive charge. If it is shifted to this side, then this carbon will be negative and that carbon will be positive. Let's show that side shift. So what you are getting is C plus and C minus. One pair of electrons is residing on this carbon and you are getting positive negative. So this is electromeric shift. That is the bonded pair of pi electron is shifting to either to that side or to this side. This happens when a nucleophile like Cn minus or an electrophile like E plus, you can write NO2 plus, when an electrophile comes close to this. When Cn minus comes, what happens? When Cn minus comes, it is an nucleophile in the pair of electrons. So Cn minus will be attached to the positive carbon. If it is E plus, then E plus will be attached to the negative carbon. So let's see with Cn minus how it works. Cn minus, one pair of electron is coming. So this pair of electron will be attached to this carbon, which is positive. Negative will attack the positive part. So what you are going to get is Cn will get attached to that, and here H, ionization changes from sp2 to sp3, then here C minus H. So minus will be getting attached to the plus, plus will be getting attached to the minus. So this is electromeric effect, that is the movement of bonded pair of this pi electron shifting to either to that side or to this side. That is electromeric effect. Then if it is H plus, what happens? If it is H plus, see, it is an electrophile. Electrophile will get attached to this minus part. So here the product will be C, H, H. That way positive is here. And this negative C, on this negative C, then H plus will be getting attached. So the product is obtained in this way. There is an electromeric effect. There is a movement of pi electrons either to that carbon or to this carbon. So electrophile will be attached to the negative portion and nucleophile will be attached to the positive portion. Next, we are going to do hyperconjugative effect. That is the movement of sigma electrons. You know that sigma electrons are very strong electrons, normally they do not move. But if sigma electron of the CH bond, you can consider this carbon with a positive charge, means there is an orbital, weak energy orbital. This is a weak energy orbital. It is perpendicular to the plane of this. You can see in 120 angle, this CH and this CH, and that the vacant p orbital is perpendicular to that plane. Now, CC single bond, free rotation is possible around the CC single bond. So, this carbon along with its height, then will be rotating. When this bond comes in alignment with this p orbital, this pair of electrons will be given here and the single bond will become a double bond. H will go as H plus. H will be going as H plus and the bonded pair of electrons will be moving to make a next bond between carbon and carbon. So, what does hyperconjugate effect? It is a delocalization. Delocalization of the sigma bonded electrons to a vacant p orbital. Delocalization of sigma electrons of CH of alkyl group connected to a carbon with a vacant p orbital. That is called hyperconjugative effect. Means if C plus is attached to a CH3, CH. Then what will happen? CH3 can rotate a pair of electrons. What is that? That is what is happening here. When this CH bond comes in alignment with this, that pair of electrons can be coordinated. You can consider due to this rotation, when this CH bond comes in alignment, then that pair of electrons can be coordinated to that p orbital. And again you see a rotation, when this CH bond comes in alignment with that vacant p orbital, that pair can be coordinated to make a bond between C and C. So three times this can donate pairs of electrons. This can donate pair of electrons, or this can donate pair of electrons, or this can donate pair of electrons. For that, the CC bond free rotation, or the CC bond free rotation is possible. So this carbon with its pair of electrons can be rotated. When this comes in alignment with the space at p orbital, vacant p orbital, that pair of electrons can be donated. Similar is the case with this, that means three times this donation is possible. You can consider here also CH. So from there also three times bonded pair of electrons can be, there is sigma bonded pair of electrons. This is delocalized. You can consider here also the same situation. Now what happened? Nine times this is possible. Nine times. From here three times. From there three times. From here three times. So nine times the delocalization of the bonded pair of electrons of CH bond to the vacant p orbital of this C plus. This is a central C plus. This carbon is connected to three C and three carbons. This carbon is connected to three carbons. We call it as tertiary carbon. So nine times this is stabilized. Nine times this donation is possible. So C plus, which is tertiary carbon cation is more stable than secondary. What is secondary? Secondary means see. This carbon is connected to two carbons. This is called the secondary, which is stable than primary. What is primary? This is primary. This carbon is connected to only one carbon. So this is primary. So tertiary carbon cation is more stabilized than secondary, which is again more stabilized than primary. So what is hyperconjugate effect? The localization of sigma electrons of CH bonds of CH3 or an alkyl group directly connected to a carbon with a vacant p orbital. Suppose there is no vacant p orbital. Instead of there is an unsaturated system like this. If it is an unsaturated system, you have to first polarize it. Means electrons can be shifted that side or this side. So electrons can be shifted to one side so that you have to create a C plus over there. So create a C plus over there. A C plus means there is a vacant p orbital. Means you have to prepare, you have to find out a vacant p orbital, and to that you are attaching to this CH3. So I am writing a CH3 here. C double bond H, then CH3. Now suppose this is the case. You need a C plus. C for C plus, you can polarize that towards that. So this is the C plus. That C plus is carrying the negative orbital. Now the square of electron can be coordinated then. X will be going as H plus and a new double bond will be formed there. So what is hyperconjugate effect? Hyperconjugate effect is the delocalization of sigma electrons of CH bond of alkyl group directly attached to an atom with a vacant p orbital. That is hyperconjugate effect. Means my point is only this much: a CH3 group is an electron donating through its three CH bonds along this hyperconjugate effect. So both CH3 or methyl group, either group, generally alkyl group is an electron donating group. That's our hyperconjugating effect. With that, we finish that chapter 12. We almost took more than 1 month for that chapter 12. Now we are going to chapter 13, hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons. In class 10, we have already learned hydrocarbons, methane, ethane, propane, butane, methane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane. That means so many hydrocarbons we have learned. Hydrocarbon is a compound comprising carbon and hydrogen. Hydrocarbons are alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. Three types. And aromatic hydrocarbons, benzenoid hydrocarbons and non-benzenoid hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons containing benzene ring are called benzenoid hydrocarbon, and aromatic compounds with no benzene ring, still they are aromatic, non-benzenoid aromatics. So then we will be learning aromatic hydrocarbons, we will be learning after. So first we will be learning alkanes, then alkenes, then alkynes. And guys, then aromatic hydrocarbon. First, let's come to alkanes. Alkanes, methane, ethane, propane, butane, etc. How can you prepare this hydrocarbon? What are the characteristic physical properties? What are the chemical properties? What are the uses? So, what we are learning is preparation properties and uses. So preparation. For preparation, you can start from alkenes. Alkenes on hydrogenation. In presence of nickel, palladium, or platinum. You can have CH3. You go to the staff room and get good chalks. Big chalks from the bigger boxes. From alkenes, you can add hydrogen to form alkane. If it is from alkyne, that is CH triple bond CH, then two modes of H2 can be utilized for one mode of alkyne. So 2H will be going there, 2H will be going there. So here CH triple bond CH. Thank you. Next is from alkyl halide. Alkyl halide with again hydrogenation is by adding H2. H2 in presence of H2. How can we make this H2? Metal acid. That is ZnHCl. Metal acid. To form CH4. CH4. Then what? This H from here and CH from here. So with metal acid can give hydrogen. You can prepare alkane, that is methane. Another method of preparation is this is called hydrogenation. Means the reaction with the hydrogen is called hydrogenation. Another method of preparation is by Wood's reaction. This is again from alkyl halide only. Alkyl halide CH3Cl plus metallic sodium. Plus again C3Cl once again I write it in presence of dry needle. Dry needle, no moisture should be there because you know that because the sodium burns in moisture. So there should not be any moisture, no water. So we are going to be doing in dry needle medium or ethereal medium. So what happens to NaCl will be removed from here and CS will be connected to CS3. CS3 means doubling. In this case, doubling of carbon COC in the product side. This is called Wood's reaction. Wood's reaction, you can do with alkyne and one aryl also. If it is only aryl, we say the reaction like this. Cl plus 2 Na plus Cl. One benzene, no benzene. So here. This 2NaCl will be going, so you will be getting diphenyl or biphenyl, but this is aromatic. What we are learning is aromatic, aliphatic. Or you can do one aliphatic and one aromatic, then you will be getting a mixed. That is, if it is CS3O, then you will be getting mixed. Toluene. This is toluene. CS3O connected to benzene, that is toluene. So, by Wood's reaction, you can make this hydrocarbons. Next is decarboxylation reaction. By decarboxylation reaction means the removal of carbon dioxide. Removal of carbon dioxide, that is CH3COONA in presence of soda lime. Soda lime is a mixture of NaOH and calcium oxide. Here, CH4 will be formed and Na2CO3. 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 And it's carbon dioxide bond along this. From here, CO2. CO2 bond, that's called decarboxylation reaction, Na2CO3. You can do it with aromatic also. If you are putting C6H5COONA here, then you will be getting benzene over here. This is decarboxylation. Again, you are preparing a hydrocarbon. But this is aromatic hydrocarbon. In the aromatic case, you can put CS3 or C2H5 here accordingly. The corresponding hydrocarbon will be obtained. Next is Kolbe electrolytic methods. Kolbe electrolytic methods. Kolbe electrolytic methods. It's by electrolysis. For that, you are taking CH3COO- and Na+. On putting in water, this minus and plus will get separated. So you are putting in water on you and passing electricity. Electricity, passing electricity. So these get detached and CH3C OO minus and Na plus from this. CH3 COO minus and Na plus. Now what happens here? The CH3 COO minus, I am taking that CH3 COO minus separately. CH3, what is my CH3 COO minus? Here on XY electron is it? So that electron from twice, you take from twice, so twice CH3 COO minus. Remove two electrons. So what you are getting from your case, twice CH3COO, right? That is minus two electrons. One electron from one and the other electron from the other. So what they are going to get is CH3COO, right? From the CH3COO, right? Means you see there is the formation of a stable small compound carbon dioxide. For that, it is like this. C double bond O, C, three, right? So this bond will be broken like that, where electron will be taken to form the CO2, and CO2 will be going as a gas. So minus CO2, how many CO2 and then 2 CO2. So here, twice CH3, three, right, will be formed. And this one CH3, three, right, will be making a bond with another CH3, three, right, C twice. So you'll be getting C2X, or I direct the CH3 bond to CH3. Doubling of the carbon number. Doubling of the carbon number in the compound is occurred. So it is a step of reaction. Methane cannot be prepared by this method because methane contains only one carbon, but here you see doubled the number of carbon. So doubling, since the doubling occurs, methane cannot be prepared by Galway electrolytic methods. Let's come to the physical properties of this. Physical properties in the sense they are melting point, they are boiling point, they are solubility. You know that methane is a gas, ethane is a gas, propane is a gas, but butane, it can be compressed into a liquid also, that is it. That can be liquefied. That's how we are making LPG, liquefied petroleum gas. So methane is a pakka gas, CH4, ethane is a gas, propane onwards, then what is the cost increases? So first a few numbers are gases, then liquids and has to come to decade and not of the solid. So this is the situation. When it comes to methane is a gas. Methane and another methane molecule only there is one per source of attraction. Only one per source of attraction, because this is non-polar molecule, non-polar molecule. Between two non-polar molecules only when the one source of attraction is existing over there. So this since this force is a very small force, this can be easily broken, this methane molecule will be in the gaseous state. We call it as marsh gas, the nala or nali, when the gas is coming out is methane gas. Methane gas is also called a marsh gas, from the marshy areas it is coming out. So breathing this methane gas for a longer time is ultimately it leads to death. So first few members are gases, then heavier members are liquid, again heavier members are solids. Coming to pentane is a liquid that is CH3, CH2, 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 CH3. Pentane. This is C5H12 in molecular formula. This pentane can be represented in another format also showing a branch that is CH3, CH2, CH3, CH2. So this is again C5H12 only, but due to the branching, the size is somewhat coming to a spherical nature. You can consider one more, that is this normal pentane, this is isopentane and neopentane, as we learned last year. This is neopentane, this is almost in the spherical shape only. So if you take these three compounds in three different test tubes, I have taken log of pen elements, iso pen elements, and neo pen in the third one. See, that is in spherical shape. All the molecules are in spherical shape. Sphere has got the least surface area. So the contact between one neopentane molecule and the other neopentane molecule is very less, or they can be easily separated, or we think these molecules will be coming up or boiling point of neopentane is the least. Because it is somewhat having spherical nature, sphere has got the lowest surface area. So if you consider this third test tube, which has this neopentane molecule, so many neopentane molecules, the force of attraction between these molecules, that is very less. So on boiling, on heating, on giving sound, supplying heat energy, these molecules can easily come up. But this will be having greater boiling point than this, and this will be having the highest boiling point. So depends upon the structure and shape, the boiling, though they are having the same molecular formula, they will be having different boiling points. So different boiling points is due to this branching. Due to the branching, only the spherical nature comes, the surface area becomes minimum, the contact between the similar molecules will be less, they can easily escape on heating. So neopentane, due to this type of branching or spherical nature, they will be coming up very faster, or we can say the boiling point is very less in the case of neopentane. Coming to the chemical properties. Chemical properties, you have aromatization and isomerization. You can see CH3, CH2, CH2. CH2, CH3. You know, from the bigger box, no? So this is what 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is normal hexane. Normal hexane on heating with, means by applying pressure, temperature, and process of catalyst, V2O5 is the catalyst, and 773 Kelvin, 10 to 20 atmospheric pressure. 10 to 20 atmospheric pressure, you get cyclohexane. This is called aromatization, means you are making an aromatic compound, this aromatization. So this is one of the reaction by this normal hexane is aliphatic hydrocarbon to form aromatic hydrocarbon. This is what chemical property when heating in presence of catalyst, when you get pentoxide at 10 to 20 atmospheric pressure, you get this benzene. And the isomerization means the same molecular formula, you are getting different structure, that is called isomerization. For isomerization, you take normal hexane. In presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride and H2, you will get CH3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Normal hexane has 6 carbons, and this is for 2-methyl pentane. This is isomer. This is an isomer. The same molecular formula having different structure. Is called isomer. So this is another chemical property of alkene. Whose paper is the next paper? This again. Sir will be coming. You have to go. Your portion is over. This again. Okay. Thank you.